in this campaign. This was a young man that I knew quite well, for he was as if he was my own son. He gave his time and his talent to this campaign. And a few weeks ago, he went home to be with the Lord. And so what we want to do for just a moment is just have a moment of silence in remembrance of Patrick.
At this time, I'd like to take the time to introduce the Honorable Lou Diabolito. Judge Diabolito completed his undergraduate degree at Youngstown State University. He then went on to complete his Juris Doctorate from the University of Akron. Before being elected judge, he practiced law at his own law office, Lou A. Diabolito Law Office in Boardman, Ohio. He was then, in 2008, elected to the Mahoning County Court of Common Pleas. And at this time, I'd like to please welcome Judge Lou Diabolito.
I received the program this morning. I prepared the oath of office, and I was honored to be here when Tito asked me to swear to him. And I see it says remarks and oath. So I obviously have to say something. Unfortunately. What a great day for this family. And what a great day for the city of Youngstown.
Yes.
You know, I have watched Tito grow through maturity up to where he is now. I've watched how he's handled himself. And he has grown to become a professional. And he has this infectious passion for life. And every time you meet him, you smile, because he has that effect on you. And he's a good man, he's an honest man, and he's smart enough to realize that he's gonna surround himself with good people.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe he's the kind of person who's gonna be able to take in this country of ours where everybody seems to wanna fight with each other, where we have every faction fighting against another faction. He's the kind of man it's going to be able to bring people together,
yes,
to work as one and to move the city of Youngstown,
yes,
forward.
Yes.
I believe that. This isn't by chance. This isn't by luck.
All right.
There's a reason.
All right.
Well, let's give it to
you. All right.
Do solemnly swear
that I will support
uphold and defend the Constitution
of the United States
the Constitution of the State of Ohio
the Charter
the laws of Mahoning County, Ohio
that I will faithfully
honestly
diligently
and impartially perform
and discharge
all the powers and duties
incumbent upon me
as the mayor of the city of Youngstown
according to the best of my ability
and understanding
so help me God
congratulations.
Brown! So I'm just going to be brief, but I was planning to sing a song today, but as I started thinking over the time during the campaign and everything, I said, I have to sing another song about how faithful God has been. God has been so faithful.
Yes.
Even when we doubted, even when people think this started in December 2016. This goes all the way back to 2013. And we fell short in 2013, but it was God's way of saying, I still have some more preparation for you. I have to grow something in you. And that's what he has. And I'm just so, so thankful. I mean, that we've gotten it. I just didn't think this, going through this year, I didn't think we were, I don't think I was going to make it. As far as last year, this time, on this Saturday, we were burying my mother. It was my mother's funeral on this same Saturday in December of last year. So fast forward to now, you know, I know that she's smiling down. I know that all of our loved ones are just smiling down. And I just want to sing just a little bit of this song just to talk about God's faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. All I have needed, thy hand hath always provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses up above, join with all nature in manifold.
above my pay grade. She says, I do the talking, but she ministers to our heart every day. I want to first say thank you. I might not get a chance to say it again to any of you in this room or this atmosphere. I want to say thank you. It's been a long journey. And I don't want it to be one of those where I tell you how I feel, because if I did that, I'd start crying.
Right.
I don't want to start mentioning the names, because I start crying. So if you would indulge me in just an afternoon for Teal Brown to speak to you about chapters in my life, is that okay with you?
Yes, it is.
I'd like to first thank my wife for her sacrifice.
Yes, Lord.
I want to thank my children from 28, 12, and 12, and 7 for their sacrifice. And then I want to thank Mama and them for her sacrifice.
All right.
Because there's days and evenings and afternoons we know we forgot to call her and tell her the kids are coming by. So we just, oftentimes, we make sure we leave them at the curb with a box of pizza. And she's told us, don't bring Little Caesars back. So I want to thank you guys for all of that. I want to thank my family, my immediate family, my extended family. Oftentimes, people ask me, say, I ran into your cousin. Is that really your cousin? I said, I'm going to have to be honest with you. If they tell you they're my cousin, they're my cousin. Our family came from down in the foothills of Mississippi on one tank of gas to Youngstown, Ohio for jobs in the steel mill. My dad's side and my mother's side. So if they tell you they're my cousins, believe it. I want to thank this crew that I have. Judge, I have a team of volunteers, friends and family, that I could take them to D.C., and we can win any Senate or presidential race.
Yes, you can. Yes, yes, yes.
And we talk about people coming to our life for a season or a reason. Many of you come in for the season. Some come for a reason. But we all had a purpose, and that was for me, for us. Yeah. Whenever you hear me say, it's our campaign, it's not my campaign. Someone says, I'm going to stop by your headquarters. I said, no, this is your headquarters. All of your sweat, blood, and tears, the sacrifices that you had to make. For your husbands and wives, they realize where you're going. Are you going down to volunteer with the phone bank? Are you going to the bingo? Or are you going out to a fundraiser for Tito? I appreciate that. If I had to ask you to do something you're not normally comfortable doing, I appreciate that. And all of you that are in attendance today, you could have been anywhere. You could have stopped by any other place, but here today, I'm looking at the faces and it's warming my heart. I can't look at you too long because I start crying. I told you that, right? I don't know if I'm getting bushy. I'm still tough. Don't forget about that. But I'm learning how to love more. I'm learning how to be wiser. And this process has grown me. It's shown me. And then I want to say something to a guy that I don't understand what kind of medication he's on, but it's good medication. My pastor. Pastor Michael H. Harrison.
All right.
And the folks from Union Baptist, if you never come, if you ever want to see some crazy folks, stop by Union 528 Lincoln Avenue, 10 a.m. on a Sunday morning. You will see some folks crazy for the Lord. And I want to thank all of them for all your help and your sacrifice. We had this opportunity. We decided we were going to do this. We'd do swearing in. We had some bumps in the road and scheduling conflicts. I said, well, I wanted to continue on because I had family and friends who were coming from out of town, and I wanted to make sure they saw this because Grandma and them would be proud. But I'm like, who would I get to swear me in? I said, well, I need the gentleman's gentleman. Judge Lou Diapolito, you're a gentleman's gentleman. Thank you so much for your commitment to this community. Thank you for taking me and said, you'll administer the oath. He gave me some words back there of encouragement. He always can do that, words of encouragement, and I appreciate you so much, Judge. You and your lovely family, and they say the fruit don't fall far from the tree, right?
Young Jack Dowd. Thank you guys for coming. I understand there's parts in our life. There's a story we have to tell. And then there's all types of story in your life. You know, there's the stories that people tell. There's the stories in the books that you read in the library. And then there's stories like my mama and my grandmama used to watch, you know, The Young and the Restless, General Hospital. But in each story, there's a chapter. There's a part of a book. There's a part of that information. And I believe today there's a new chapter that we're turning, not only in my life, not only in the city of Youngstown, but for each one of you. Because we had a chapter that we were working on. We were working to be a team. We were working to make sure that I became the 51st mayor of the city of Youngstown. And I thank you for that chapter, for whatever part you played in that chapter of the book. The chapters in our life, they're marked by years, some tears, and some fears. But you have those chapters in your life. You have some that are shorter, some that are longer, but those are chapters in your life. Some are easy to navigate, some are just tough to get through, but they're chapters in our life. And it tells a story. It reveals who you are. So I want to tell you from the bottom of my heart, the chapters in our life, often the pages have to be turned. From your childhood to your past failures or disappointments. I've had some past failures and disappointments. But they told me delay is not denial.
All right.
Today is an opportunity for me to understand. Delay is not a denial.
That's right.
When you walk out of here, you can say, Tito Brown is the mayor of the city of Youngstown. Whether it's relationships or some friendships, that's part of your chapter in your life. Some have come, some have gone. We always have those different chapters in our life. And you have to remember those epic moments in your life. And I can go on and on about the epic parts in my life. This is my movie screen right here. They said an epic movie, this is my movie right here.
All right.
17 years old. Our first cast of character came along. He helped me grow into the man that I am today. And then we went on down the road a little further. And I said, well, you know, she had chased me long enough. I could let her have me. Well, you can verify. The first day I came on the job, she was in my face. Can I help you? You need pencils and papers? I'm like, lady, all I want to do is start my job, get to work. She was all up in my business. But I can honestly tell you, that chapter of my life, where it was my best friend, my girlfriend, now my wife. I often say she's my best political advisor because she'll tell me when none of you have the boldness to tell me what I need to be doing. We're going to argue. We're going to disagree. But I say, till death do us part. So I will listen. I might not always get it right, but I'm always doing the right thing. Youngstown has had some chapters in their life, in its life. You remember Black Monday when the steel mills closed? You remember the drug epidemic of the 90s where crack was running rampant in this community? What about the corruption of elected officials in the city of Youngstown?
Better speak.
And now, the opioid epidemic in the city of Youngstown. There was an author who said, the best part of a book that you're reading is the opportunity when you're about to turn the page because you have a new belief. There's something new on the other side of that page that you're turning. So we got to know today, here's our opportunity to turn the page. We're going to turn the page from what we used to be as Youngstown. We're not going to be corrupt. We're not going to talk about our past failures. We're going to look to the future. We're going to talk about what can versus what it used to be. And we have to focus and move away from hurt and disappointment. I can't talk about what the past mayors did. All I can talk about what I want to do. I can't talk about rereading the past chapters of the leaders of the past. And I want to be like Herman Pete Starks. I love Herman Pete Starks, but I can't be Herman Pete Starks. I can't reread the chapters of the past leaders of this community. It's time for me to write my chapter in this book in the city of Youngstown.
Yes.
I need to create a future that is bright for my children and my grandchildren. My chapter started with a 17-year-old, but now look at my 12-year-olds. You guys remember me coming around the campaign, arm length. Lynette had one and I had the other. Pulling them around. If they smile, you see where my money's going. So that's my chapters in my book. Creating a future for my 7-year-old young man, who if you ever came around the home and you ever had a chance to see us, if the men were in one room and the ladies were in another room, Quentin Brown wants to know what the men are talking about. He gets right there and sits there and listens. So I gotta make sure that we're saying the right things. We're teaching him right, because he's gonna be someone's father, someone's husband, and he's gonna be some leader in this community coming up in the future. I need to let you know that it's time for us to turn the page. We must turn the page in Youngstown and create chapters. As mayor and the 51st mayor of the city of Youngstown, I'm going to digress just 1 minute. Brian, I'm a middle linebacker. I wore number 50 at D. Rand High School. I was decent at the middle linebacker position. Joe, you know, I used to come after you. That's my cousin Joe. He was east side, I was north side. We came at you for the East Golden Bears. If I didn't have number 50, if number 51 was available, like a guy like Mike Dicka, I would have taken that number. So for me to go from 50 at D. Rand School, I'm turning the page, a new chapter. I'm going to add one to it to be 51. I just want to let you know, Booker T. Washington said it best. A man's success is not measured by the position that he holds, but by the success he's able to achieve while in that position. Ladies and gentlemen, while I'm in this position, I need you to help me be successful by any means that you're praying for me, you're supporting me, a phone call. I need your help. I need your support. It is not about me. It's about Youngstown turning the page in a new chapter for us to move forward. God bless you. Thank you. And I love you. Everyone, have a great day. That we create coalitions and relationships. That it's not just one person, but many. So I'm going to digress, if it's okay. I want Pastor Kenneth Simon to come. The great bishop of the south side of Youngstown. And I want him to come and give the benediction, because we all in this together. Amen.
Amen.
So we join hands as a sign of unity. Gracious God, our Father, we pause to say thank you again.
Thank you, Lord.
For this historic moment.
Yes.
Thank you for the move of your spirit here in the city of Youngstown. Yes. Thank you for this young man and his family.
Yes, Lord.
You have ordained for such a time as this. We pray, O God, first for his protection.
Yes, God. Jesus.
Yes, God.
Jesus.
Protect his family.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Surround him, God, with those who will influence him for good.
Yes.
Yes.
We pray for divine wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
That you will give him wisdom in his decision making.
Yes.
And that he will consult you for us.
Yes.
For you said for him to trust you with all of his heart.
Yes, Lord.
And not to lean to his own understanding.
Yes.
But in all of his ways to acknowledge you, Lord. You promised you would direct his
path. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Give him direction, God. And then I pray that you will bless this city.
Do so, God.
Bless this city, God.
Jesus.
This city that has had so many negative images portrayed about this city. I pray that you will first of all bring us together. Unite us, God. Unite us under the banner of righteousness, God. Let your presence, your power, and your peace abide in this city.
Yes.
And then, Lord, I pray that you will give us a bright future through the new leadership that you have surfaced for our community. We ask now your blessing upon him, your anointing.
Yes.
And then bless those around him, Father.
Yes, Lord.
Put our hearts and minds on one accord.
Yes.
For the betterment of this community.
Yes.
And for the glory of your kingdom.
Yes.
Dismiss us now from this swearing in service, but never from your divine presence.
Yes.
Let your love, grace, and peace be with us.